key moment, you know, at the end of regulation when I guess Pop called for the double team and Barlow came out and helped you out. I think that rattled Fox to get the ball out.
Right, yeah, obviously Fox, you know, got it going there in the fourth quarter like, you know, he has been all season. And, yeah, we were just trying to get it out of his hands in that last play to try to have someone else beat us. Yeah, whoever it was that came up, you know, made a good play on him, got him to get rid of the ball and, you know, forced overtime.
What did you see from him? You had a rookie leading you early, then a vet late. What did you see from Julian and Doug?
Right, yeah, Julian stepped up huge for us tonight. You know, he's been ready every single time his number's been called. He continues to stay ready, continues to work on his game, watch film and everything, ask important questions. And, you know, tonight he played, you know, big for us, you know, throughout the entire game. You know, Doug is just Doug. You know, at any time he's going to get it going. All he needs is, you know, one little inch to get it off, and, you know, he catches on quick.
Did you guys, were you guys looking for him, or?
A lot of it was just
off his own creation.
Right, yeah. It's tough to, you know, they don't leave him much, so it's tough to kind of look for him. Obviously, we always got a radar out for him, but we try to just, you know, continue to play our game, you know where he's at a little bit more than anybody else, but continue to play our game, and, you know, we know he's going to be cutting and moving and trying to get open as much as possible.
You guys came in 0-for-5 in overtime reserve. Something, one thing that you were saying we got to do differently this time, obviously score.
Mm-hmm. I think it's the defensive end, really. You know, that's the main thing for us. You know, we came out in overtime and they scored right away, but then we were able to string, you know, a few stops together there. I think there's a foul in the middle of it all, but we were able to get some stops, you know, in the middle of it all, and that's what really helped us. I think in those other overtime games, it's been, you know, close to or if not double figures that they're putting up in that overtime, and it's pretty quick. And so tonight we were able to come out in overtime and string together some stops there to help us get the win.
So who's the triple-double leader in the Jones family? Your mom, maybe?
Now it's tied, yeah. Because my brother obviously got that one on us earlier this year. But, you know, he already texted me and everything. He was watching, so he was super hyped. But yeah, I always appreciate that.
What does it say about this team that doesn't matter the lineup, doesn't matter who we're playing, we'll always fight, doesn't matter whoever's available, this team comes out and competes?
Right, yeah, every single night, it doesn't matter, you know, who we have in the lineup, we're going to compete at you know, all costs. You know, we got guys that are hungry, and guys are trying to prove things every single night, continue to learn, continuing to grow. And so every single night, we're going to come ready to play. We're going to try to, you know, compete as much as we can, try to do all the things we know how to do the right way, and let the rest take care of itself. But yeah, every single night we're gonna come out and compete and give it, you know, all we got.
I want to ask you about Don Barlow too, getting some good minutes against Sabonis today.
Right.
What have you seen from him from training camp to now, big minutes against an all-star?
Right. Yeah, Dom continues to grow. Yeah, he's super young, obviously, but he continues to learn. You know, every single day, he's trying to pick up so much. And he's kind of in a weird position there with, you know, playing the 4 sometimes, playing the 5 sometimes. You know, tonight he got, you know, the matchup against, you know, All-Star Sabonis, and, you know, was able to hold his own, was able to, you know, put up a great fight for us, you know, got a double-double. And he was, you know, in the right spots a lot tonight. He was flying around, getting blocks early, he was getting rebounds. You know, when guys were driving, he was finding himself in the right spot for dump offs, dunk, that short corner jump shot that he has as well. And so, you know, he's doing a lot of little things really well, and he's continuing to grow and just get more comfortable.
Did you guys risk Pop's wrath by celebrating the Hall of Fame?
Nah, we haven't done that yet. I don't know. He doesn't really like that. So we're gonna have to wait and, you know, surprise him with something good, I think, in Phoenix.
Trey, there's 15 seconds left in the game, and De'Aaron Fox got the ball. He's drilling it down to the last 5 seconds. Then all of a sudden, you guys, you know, you're on him, double team him. Can you talk a little bit about, you know, that last few seconds of what you were trying to get him not to do?
Right. Yeah. Obviously. Yeah, he's been taking over in the fourth quarter all season. I think he leads in, you know, clutch points. And so We knew that he'd have the ball in his hands and be trying to take that last shot. And we wanted to just get the ball out of his hands and, you know, force someone else to beat us. And we were able to rotate on the backside well and force a tough shot that ended up helping us get to overtime.
And at the end of overtime, the first person he went to go greet was you. What did he say to you at the end of the game, man?
Yeah, just to keep going, continue to work on my craft every single day, and continue to get better. I've known him since high school. He went against my brother, and then as we got older, then I went against him at USA camp and stuff. So it all comes full circle. Obviously, most of us competed against each other when we were younger and everything. And, you know, we're friends off the court.
Thanks, Trey.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, Trey.